Hello, everyone. There's a new version of PySN coming soon, and we are changing the format to document its functionalities. So starting with the upcoming update, we'll include a test or demo folder, here named Demo132. That folder will be included in the installation files and has test source files as well as output files. This will allow you to play with PySN and compare results. You could even evaluate the output prior to any installation to see if a feature is useful. Okay, so inside the demo folder, there are subfolders. There will be some exceptions, but the general rule I intend to follow is to create a folder per type of feature and do one video at a time per feature. So the videos are going to be shorter. For example, Import to SN showcases importing graphics and handwritings to editable Supernote notebooks. It has a subfolder for importing icons with some input files and the output files in an output folder. Another example is the Shapes folder with some inputs. Let me quickly show how I am proceeding by running PySN just for these shapes. By the way, I had to implement quite a few changes to make the existing code compatible with the higher resolution of the Manta. So this question about the type of device you see here is to associate and store the type of device with its serial number. It will be stored in your settings, and you won't have to input it again in the future. A similar dialog happens when you first connect through Wi-Fi. Let me be clear that this is still a bit new, so I can't rule out that mixing Manta and Nomad files won't have some unanticipated effect down the road. Back to the methodology. After I ran PySN, I collect the output files and put them in an output subfolder. Oh, before moving on to the topic of the day, let me mention the fact that notebooks created by PySN now offer a preview without the need to switch to landscape. You see that faint recycle icon on the top right? That's your clue that the Supernote hasn't rendered yet the vector points. You can still switch to landscape and dot, or select all, and slightly expand the selection to have a proper rendering that recycles the temporary placeholder image. Okay, I hope you don't judge my lack of artistic talent for these shape creation examples. Mr. Clown here isn't judgmental, and he has a happy dance. All right, back to today's topic. Let's export some of the text behind highlighted PDFs to an editable Supernote notebook. As for all PySN PDF annotations, we have to indicate a destination folder and make sure that the path to the files contains a certain text. Here, digest in. So here the destination folder is set to be the merged PDF subfolder of our demo. Let me also direct PySN to only process the digest in folder. This functionality existed already a couple of months ago, but please bear with me, there is a cool new feature. Okay, we're heading to the Digest In folder, and we're going to highlight some random sections of the PDF using the highlighter tool. Maybe not so random. To illustrate a feature, let's finish our last highlight at page 5. Now, as you know, the Supernote shows you the highlights annotations in the table of contents, and those annotations appear in the order of the pages. The reason I wanted to end with page 5 is to show you that PySN will keep track of the annotation timeline. You can also see on the table of contents that there are no other annotations besides the highlights. We're done with the inputs. Let's head to the destination folder and launch PySN. This time, as you can see, it knew that the serial number of the connected device was an N5, aka Manta. Looking at the execution log, you can see that the script uses the Sago font and generated 3 preview images. So what did we get? 3 files, a PDF file, a note file, and a text file. Let's start with the PDF, and let me also open the file that PySN backed up on my PC. And here is the last annotation group of bookmarks, in descending order, meaning that the bookmark on top is the last highlight we made on page 5. This may be useful to find what you last annotated. Of course, you have the same bookmark on the Supernote. Now let's take a look at the text file, which is actually a markdown file. I am changing the extension file to show it on the Supernote because at this time, Supernote doesn't support the markdown format. When you open the same file on the PC with the .md extension in a Markdown viewer, you can see that this is indeed a valid, though basic, Markdown file. Here is a side-by-side test to show that the Markdown file contains the text that was highlighted. The content of the Markdown file will be used by PySN to create a notebook from scratch. PySN will use the style settings, in this case settings for headings of level 2, to style our pseudo-headings in the notebook. So let's examine the notebook that PySN created from scratch. As mentioned before, we have a preview image that was generated, and we can see the recycle icon on the top right. We have the Sago fonts from our ASCII table. If you don't know what that means, please refer to previous videos about the text to notes feature. Oh, I just realized that the vertical offset for the letters such as F, G, Q, Y in this demo are off, so the text may be a bit difficult for you to read. I will fix this before the release. The pseudo headings are shown in the table of contents, and you can quickly move to the relevant page. For example, I can click on the page 4 heading, and I am directed to the page containing the highlighted text that was on page 4 of the source PDF file. Let's do this again for page 13. You have been very patient watching till this point, and here is the new hidden feature. If you click or tap to the heading on the Supernote, you are directed to the corresponding page of the PDF source file. Not a copy, but the original source file. As you can see, when I close that file, I am in the source digest in folder. Now that link, combined with the powerful backlinks of the Supernote, allows you to go back and forth between your editable notebook and the PDF. You know what? I think if we can export not only the text, but also the selected graphical content to the new notebook, we will have an ideal digest functionality to review all sorts of PDF files. No limitation of space to comment because you are using a notebook with all edit features. But that's going to be a PySN 2.0 feature or better, something entirely done with the Supernote Partner app. Most of PySN features require computation from a PC, and so does the Partner app. It could integrate these features in a much more intuitive and elegant way. What do you think about that? Please leave a note in the comments below. Okay, we're almost done. Two more things that are worth mentioning. First, to force the rendering of this type of documents, you can of course go through the annoying landscaping and dotting procedure. But for the Manta, you could just select anything and click out of the selection zone to force a rendering and recycle the placeholder. Keep in mind that rendering will no longer be an issue once RATA publishes their SDK. Second, this is a real-time recognition notebook, and this means that everything, including subsequent digest comments, can be recognized by the native recognition engine. Pretty cool, huh? Let's accelerate the recognition here. And let's search for data. It is found. Let's do a digest example. And after a forced recognition is performed to shorten this video, let's look for dig, which is found. All right, folks, this is it for today. Version 1.32 will be on GitLab on January 20th. Thank you for watching. Please hit the subscribe and notification buttons to get future videos. Happy writing.